Chase Lee Hockey with the Bull Food Ton. In this review, I don't expect a lot of views, but anyway, I saw Snowflake Mountain. Are these snowflakes going to melt? Are they going to go into icebergs? Let's find out. So knowing me, I do not like reality TV. Survivor, Amazing Race, stuff like that. That's just not stuff I like to watch. But Snowflake Mountain, I was like, okay, that looks like there's some charm to it. So let me watch this 8-episode, you know, reality TV show and see if it holds up. But what is Snowflake Mountain about? Pretty simple premise. 9 of 10 snowflakes ranging from 19 to about, say, 25 years old live off their parents, do everything their parents do. They're lazy. They bitch and moan. They don't know anything about the real world. They've been sheltered their whole life. And now they're going to this so-called real world scenario in the woods to try to survive and not become snowflakes. So did I like this reality series? I thought it was okay. Some good stuff. But overall, it is very superficial. So with that, I'll give you the negatives of the movie first. So yeah, like I said, one of the negatives is very superficial about what is actually happening. I was expecting it to be a little bit more extreme. But if they made it a little bit too extreme, I can see all these snowflakes just bowing out at the first or second day because it's like, I can't do this no more. It's just ridiculous. So yeah, that was kind of silly. Some stuff can be extreme overall is like maybe skinning the deer because that is something very different for a lot of people to actually see where the food comes from. But like chopping a tree down or climbing a tree or climbing a mountain. Like I climbed Mount Pico. And it wasn't that hard. I mean, some of the stuff you watch, you're like, that's not hard at all, like whatsoever. But a lot of them are not in shape and do stuff like that. There's maybe one or two, maybe three tops I would say, okay, they're probably in shape to do something, but the rest were not in shape at all. Rather than being superficial, it just, some stuff did feel fake or very glamorous, if you want to put it that way. This is not really camping. I saw reviews calling it glamping. They're in nice tents. They are in, you know, okay environment. Nothing absolutely bonkers ridiculous. So it's like they weren't really in the woods. They had a good shelter. They had decent food. They had a campfire. They had a kitchen. They had, okay, the bathrooms weren't the greatest, but it wasn't like ridiculous. Like this is in the complete shit like Jack's Valley or like some stuff I've seen like my brother has done in Boy Scouts when seeing some of his living conditions. Like that's complete shit. Here it's like that ain't bad at all. There, so other than being like superficial and you know, if some of it felt fake or just like I wouldn't say fake, but it was like that really isn't that hard. If that's hard for you, but other than that, it is fun watching these people grow, and I do think it's not a fake growth. You could tell by the facial expressions and stuff they do that you're like, okay, I could see that person really change. To me, the biggest change was Sonny. Him to me was no joke, he literally grew hardcore, and I think he should have like been in the top, you know, winner of this thing, but it is what it is. But I think Sonny is the one that grew the most. Some people, I think they were mostly stationary, some people did quit, and I think adding one person into like season 3, Francesca, I think that was an okay idea, but overall it was just like, did it really need to happen? So this is gonna be a short review of Snowflake Mountain. I did enjoy what I was watching. I did see growth. I did see some fun. Some shit was actually pretty funny in this show of what they were saying. But overall, I wish it was more extreme. There was one episode where they went into that military aspect of like getting the down position and wait for your teammates to show up while money gets off the clock. I wish it was more like that, where I was like, hurry up, hurry up, hurry up. But that really wasn't there. But overall, Snowflake Mountain, it's an okay show. If you want to have some laughs and just see, you know, people enjoy nature and people not be less angry. And I think that's what we need in this world is people to be a lot less angry because a lot of people are still just like a powder keg ready to explode. And I think this show shows that enjoy nature, enjoy life, don't be that powder keg. So Snowflake Mountain will receive a 3 out of 5 Blue Futons, which equals at 60%. Let's see if there are critics and user scores for this one. So you have critics a 0% with 6 of them. Audience score 80% with 5. I'm curious what the negatives are. We have a 2 out of 4. We have a 3 out of 5, which that actually should be a positive. A bunch of adults complaining about life, taking a dump in a latrine. Like I said, it's silly fun, and I want to see growth. I saw growth, and I saw just, you know, it was a fun little time. So 0-60-80. Chase Hawk with the Blue Futon. Like, comment, subscribe. Let me know what you think of Bluefutonopia. You Bluefutonians, thank you for watching and have a great day. And peace of love to every single one of you. Don't be angry. Don't be that powder keg.